Okay.
The first one that jumped out at me too was the one that had a very close vote for referral, and that was number 14, which was the eligibility of championships. If you've been playing with a student or had played with a student athlete who was ineligible, lively discussion on whether it should be referred, and it got defeated by referral by a scant 11 points, 238 to 227 with 8 abstaining. That would have referred it back to be discussed more. So I'm thinking, geez, if it's that close to refer, there is no way this is going through.
Right.
And it goes through with flying colors with only 80 against it. This basically means that technically the championships committee could turn around, or the championships committee for that sport could turn around and say, you played with an ineligible student athlete. That's X amount of games. We've eliminated you from the ability to even compete. It's nullification. That's an option that they have. Call it the nuclear option, for lack of a better description. I found that fascinating and one that seemed to slip through initially until the discussions came up that day.
You know, my understanding of this nullification principle is that it's actually a little more user-friendly than the current process that D3 has been using, which is forfeiture. Right. And so that for a school that has competed against an institution that had been an eligible player, that contest is now considered to be null, as opposed to the prior approach of that contest being a forfeit. The records go away. It's like the contest never existed.
Sure.
I think to some extent now this puts institutions that, through no fault of their own, end up competing against someone who's ineligible, it puts them in a better position. That's my understanding. It's a concept that's been used successfully in D2 for several years, so it's a concept that's been tried and proven to be successful. The one other piece in the proposal that I think caused a little bit more heartburn than it needed to was the idea that the minimum fine that currently can be imposed against the school that did have the ineligible player has been, under this proposal, is going to be reduced. So the fine used to go from $500 to $5,000. This proposal changed it to say there's really no specific minimum. It's going to be up to the Secondary Infractions Committee to determine what kind of minimum they like. Apparently, $250 is more an example of the kind of fine that they might impose.
Yeah, but it's interesting too that a school could thus, if let's say they had two games, those games are nullified, they could risk the chance of not even competing in a championship tournament. Granted, timing has everything to do with this.
Right.
And this isn't something that, you know, in February you also have an ineligible player. It's determined in time. But I just thought that was an interesting twist.
Yeah, I think the championships committee, and I defer to their judgment on something like this, feels like this is a more fair way to deal with those unfortunate circumstances and the current forfeiture problem.
Well, not only does it put the game in null, which doesn't hurt the team you played against, but it puts your season in a little bit more jeopardy. You got to be a little bit more careful.